So I thought I would do a review of the QRx Labs glycolic acid 30% gel peel for y'all. I looked up this peel online because I've been having some really awesome skin. I live in really dry weather and this is me without my beautiful makeup. I know, it's so good. Anyways, it's just like a chemical peel. You can kind of do at home and it's a little bit less invasive. I know my hair's looking so good, but it's a little bit less invasive than like the stuff that they do and like sell like with like a real esthetician, you know? So I thought I'd give it a try. It was $20 on Amazon. And I read like, you basically just put it on, deal with the pain for 3 minutes, and then you wash it off with like a, they said that like you can buy like the stuff that it comes with, like they suggested stuff, or like you can use baking soda with water. So I'm gonna try that and see like the improvement of my skin. I've just been like having really dry skin and my like dead skin cells tend to build up really, really fast on my skin. I get lots of blackheads, like especially right through here. So thought I'd do a tutorial for y'all. So yeah, just comes in this little bottle. It's a 1 fluid ounce. And then you do a little dropper and you just go ahead and put it on your skin like this. Ta-da. I am not a professional. I know I'm gonna get lots of comments about how awesome my hair is because last time I did a video like this, people thought it was so kind too that they felt the need to comment about how awesome my hair was and how it was such a mess and all that stuff, but that's okay. Haters gonna hate. But yeah, so I am on like 15 seconds with this on my face and it is burning. As you can see, the pain in my little eyes. Holy dang it, it is pretty awesome. So they suggest, they say, okay, you can like try it for 1 minute, or like some people said on like the reviews and stuff, like you can see it's kind of getting red throughout there. They say do a thin layer on the website. The directions actually don't come with the bottle that I bought through Amazon. They refer you to the website and you get the directions there. It says stay away from like the line of your lips because that's a super sensitive area, and then like your nostrils because that membrane's super sensitive, and then you definitely don't want to get the stuff in your eyes because it kills. So don't get it too close to your eyes and like stay away from like, see that little inner part of your eye right there, any place that. Okay, so I'm back and I rinsed off my face with just some lukewarm water, and then I finished it up with the baking soda and water rinse, and it just kind of helps to reset the pH on your face, and it just kind of takes off like all the dead skin through here. You can kind of see, like if you look close, some of that dead skin kind of coming off. And I know like I'm red throughout here, and like you can kind of see like right here there was like, I had some acne that's right there, and I had like an acne right there that just kind of were a little bit agitated by it. The redness should dissipate within like 24 hours-ish, depending on like how sensitive your skin is. And you can, you can do the glycolic acid pills once a week, and it helps a ton like with fine lines and wrinkles and with blackheads and acne. Some people will worry because after they do like a peel that they'll develop acne. Well, that's just because we have acne sometimes underneath the surface of our skin, and it will resurface. So it'll surface like up under those new skin layers, so they'll kind of come up a little bit more. So just make sure you're doing your regimens. It's super important to have like consistency and just making sure you wash your face morning and night and follow up with a really good moisturizer. So anyways, thanks for watching.